Seguinte, galera, a gente vai estar acompanhando nesse exato momento a final da bracket eliminatória, Wes vs Sandstorm, Rayman vs Mordex. Vamos ver o que, que vai dar isso aqui. Que isso, mano? Começou assim, olha o dano, ele tá intacto ainda, mano. Finally manages to pick up that side, but Wes is still pummeling him, bro. Like, he has not been touched yet. Wes says, give me Kano right now, bro. Like, you need to stop all this Sandstorm glazing. You gotta talk about me more. I'm like, all right, bro, you got it. Ooh, hold on, reverse from Sandstorm, though. Gotta put me in my place.
Oh, that was a spot dodge from Wes. He was going for the gravity cancel side sig, but Sandstorm got him before that sig could come out. That was a burn dodge, but Wes able to get back down safely.
Que isso, rapaz? Que isso?
Yeah, Sandstorm did a really good job adding up some damage onto Wes, because Wes was making it look a little free to start that one off. But once again, he's back over to the gauntlets, something that worked really well to kick off game number one.
All right, let's see how the Sandstorm find this KO, though. Goes a little bit cheeky. The Scythe was actually still in play there, so he was able to pick it back up, but not without taking a little bit of extra damage. Needs a D-Light in the corner or something. Tries to go for the side light. I love these weapon throws he's doing to cover his way back up, but ooh, that didn't hit him? That's wild, bro.
Stayed just underneath it, kept his head under the corner, but I gotta give a shout-out to Wes on his adjustment against Sandstorm. Sandstorm's gone for that up toss into unarmed recovery three times. First one hit, after that, Wes is like, I'm a drift just enough to the side, and I'll punish you when you come up.
You see, he tries to get the D-Light into the jump side air, but it's not going to connect there. Finally does manage to find that recovery, though, and Sandstorm manages to remove that first stock off of Wes, but Wes has been looking so strong and powerful in this elimination side finals.
Right, nice start from Sandstorm. Good recognition of where the stage was. I'm not sure what camera he's playing on, but on our cam, I had no idea he was going to touch down on the ground.
Ooh.
Caraca, ele já recuperou todo o dano, velho.
On the spot, Doctor, thought we might see like a light side light into N-Sig maybe, but instead says, no, I'll go for a little bit more hits, and then the side air is gonna be enough, and just like that, Sandstorm responds back, and you can already feel the crowd becoming more alive. They love when Sandstorm has the lead.
Yeah, I mean, I think the more Sandstorm pushes a victory, then the more the crowd's gonna just start waking up, because you know they want the Sandstorm victory, but they don't want to increase it by getting too excited just yet. Wes, with the side sig, trying to even up the stock count, down heavy, not gonna connect.
Oh, and he gets yoinked as well. Are we gonna try to go for the starve? And there we go, that weapon throw into the recovery again. And he picks up another. If he got that sidelight, that would have for certain been Wes's stock. But still, so much damage has been amassed from that one interaction. Sandstorm's just turned up.
Yeah, he's really figured out what he needs to do. Wes will clean up the stock with the unarmed recovery. Can't say it's over just yet, because, of course, Wes still has some health to play with.
Oh, and there again, does the dodge in place. You know Sandstorm's gonna be scouting that one out now. Might even go for the same setup to an end sig. No, instead goes for a recovery off of that end light. And I don't know, Wes, how do you bring yourself back down to this one? Maybe a down sig?
Ooh, okay. Good decision making coming out.
Machado do Wes faz trabalhinho bom, viu? Ele consegue recuperar.
Okay, and Sandstorm just getting the free damage there with the end light. Doesn't want to go for a side light setup.
Caraca, essa side air foi certeiro, viu?
Precarious first stock. Still looking really good on that Rayman, though. I still feel like this set could go either way.
Sandstorm, big fan of the... Oh, okay.
Mudança de pique, galera. Mudança de pique de mapa. Wes agora tá de Roman Reigns. Teros.
Yeah, I mean, looking exactly like Kaina. Maybe even trying to play a little bit of the psychological game, saying, well, if I look like Kaina, he might respond to me like I am. And honestly, Wes, at this point, you're in the elimination side finals. You got to start whipping out all the stops you can to try to give yourself any edge you could possibly have. But I don't know if it'll be that easy to confuse Sandstorm.
Well, so far, it's not doing the worst job. Again, Wes has quite the axe.
Wow.
Caraca, nice GC, mano. Muito rápido, reage muito rápido.
What a wake up from Wes.
All right, Sandstorm definitely kind of taking the Taro's pain this weekend for sure. I mean, kind of already giving him a taste. And look at Wes goes for the unarmed down air as well. And he's still hunting. He is not slowing down. That's that South American gameplay we came to know and love, baby.
West feeling real good about this. Taros going full on aggression. Sandstorm, though, has West unarmed, and that's going to be another down light. But West was high enough in the sky.
Wow.
Yeah. Had to go for extra there to guarantee the KO.
Yeah, active frames on that side. Recovery always lingering a little bit more than you think it does. Manages to catch out that unarmed down air from West. And now Sandstorm has brought the stock hat back to even, but still has quite a bit of damage to make up for here. That side air is definitely going to hurt.
Yeah, I mean, he's...
Caraca, sigo certeira, bicho. Na moralzinha. Vamos lá.
Man, yeah, he's like channeling the ancestors right now, the way he's doing this. I don't know if like South America just has like this little thing they can just tap into and they can just channel each other, kind of like Ben 10 be doing. You just hit the Omnitrix set, kind of, and slap his wrist.
No, it's the hive mind. All South Americans have just that pocket Roman Reigns.
Oh.
Two hit. Some more there. Goes for that turnaround down air, but Sandstorm getting away from it, but he's still taking a lot of hits here. Good spot dodge, good reaction from Sandstorm. Can he finish this?
Oh, interesting.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure what he was trying to cover with that option there, but wasn't quite what he was looking for. It looks like Wes ended up being a little bit trickier. Sideline.
Agora ele vai ficar com um martelo, né, mano? Esperamos que ele consiga lidar bem.
But Sandstorm has taken quite a beating on his final stock here.
Yeah, we've seen that gravity cancel sidelight come out from Sandstorm before. Usually it's towards the stage.
Right.
But I think he's doing it as just like a very safe option. If it hits, it can lead to some good stuff.
GG.
He was like, I'm just gonna keep playing aggressive.
Mudança de skin, galera. Isso daí pode afetar pra caramba. Sacanagem. Mas, ixi. Resetar. Ok, voltamos.
You know, this isn't traditionally what I would have expected for Taros, right? Like, usually if you're picking Western Air Temple, it's because you have something that reaches up to those soft platforms, which Taros doesn't really have, but he's able to swing hard, so I think he's happy to have it anyways.
Yeah, I mean, the way he's just talking to him like that, too, down air, goes for the down sig immediately. I like it, too, because a lot of people like to dodge down and in off of those down airs, and so that was just kind of a quick little chump check to see if Sandstorm was autopiloting, but he did not fall for it. Oh, man, with the instant just... Ash land onto the plaque, you know, platform cancel that down stick. Like, how is Sansa supposed to react to that?
So hard to react to. I think one of the other big things about this map is like he's trying to take away that from Sandstorm because the ceiling is so high that gauntlet recovery is going to be a lot harder to KO for Sandstorm.
But he said, you know what, I'll just do it again. You know, like,
it still eventually will.
I still have the button, you know, and it's like, all right, Sandstorm, you got that. And now he's sitting here with a little bit of a lead here, wanted to get that starve. He doesn't even pick up those gauntlets again. He thought it would be too scary, and then he gets a little bit too close. And you know what they always say, every time there's a Taros on the screen, you mess with the bull, you get the horns. That's it. It's that simple.
Dude, Wes, I mean, he's just going big on that social distancing, saying, you're getting too close to my bubble. I don't like it. Gonna hit you with that down sick every time you get just a little too close.
Oh, my gosh, man. He's getting chopped up like the lumberjack really in town, and Sandstorm is every tree in the forest. Like, we gotta slow this one down a little bit. Sandstorm trying to get something with this side. He's just getting juggled over and over. These nairs have been so oppressive. He tries to do the left-right game, gets caught by either a sidelight or a neutral light from West. Well, hold on. Opportunity for some huge scything. Nope, not quite gonna happen. But hold on. Active input is my friend. He got the dodge. He got it a while there, but Sandstorm's still cooking here. Hold on. Ooh, that's gonna hurt.
Tried to go for a big player at the top of the map. Went for that gravity cancel sidelight. Does manage to get past the down air, and this is gonna be a nice position for Sandstorm, but respects West. Could have gone for a greedy gravity cancel neutral sig if Sandstorm got over eager.
Yeah, he actually goes for that downlight to the side there. I really thought Sandstorm wanted.
Caraca, muito bom.
Stock, and that kind of cost him an opportunity a little bit as West once again gets the lead, but it's not by much. But as we were talking about before, you have that high ceiling on this stage, and he has the scythe here, so probably going to be looking for maybe these falling side airs or maybe sidelights to push into the corner. But he needs something, and every single time he gets tagged by West, it matters that much more. Goes for the side air again, and does the gravity cancel and light recovery. Cheeky stuff from Sandstorm, and it's going to be enough. He gets to pick and cycle which weapon he wants here going into to the final stock of West.
I'd be surprised if it's not Scythe, and you can color me surprised because he wants to have the gauntlets to go up against West on these final stocks. And this is arguably one of the most pivotal games for the two of them because this is the one that gives them that advantage going into the final map pick. But West with the big hits, he's got the axe.
There's nothing worse than trying to watch someone break their way through and try to open up someone in neutral against Axe and just getting chunked and chunked and chunked because you can just feel victory getting smacked that much harder away. It's crumbling like there's perforations. Oof.
Now he's got the hammer, also a chunking weapon. Goes low there. All right, Sandstorm has him off stage. Nice recovery. staying out there, goes for the spot dodge.
Caraca, os dois sem recurso nenhum.
And I like the idea there from Sandstorms too, saying if West dodges here, I can kind of like tech chase with a gravity cancel and maybe get like a down tick or something. Oh!
Caraca, muito bom, Sayer. 2-1, mano, 2-1. Possível final com Brasil versus Brasil. Novamente, né? Porque a gente teve um campeonato que foi assim também. Mano, acho que o Sandstorm vai mandar pro Tesca, velho. Meu Deus. Olha lá, olha lá. Olha o Tesca, amarelão. Ih, rapaz. Cara, último recurso aí do menino Sandro. O Tesca. Com a nova cor, inclusive. Até onde você é a nova cor. Ih, teve um bom começo. Aí as sigs do Tesca vão começar, mano, a fazer efeito. Ai, dá uma dor no coração.
Already throws out that side signature. West threw out some sigs of his own, but he wants the axe spawn. It's over on the right side, and Sandstorm knows that's what he wants. Instant denial and the pickup neutral air.
And the wild part about this, I think, wow, that recovery was almost enough. Sandstorm looking for that final blow. But if there's anyone who kind of knows what Tesca can do, it's going to be West. We cannot forget that West also has played Tesca. D-Light side.
Caraca, velho. Mas lembrando muito bem que o narrador tava falando que se tem alguém que conhece o Tesca, é o West, porque ele jogou bastante tempo de Tesca. Aprimorando e tal, personagens, campeonatos. Então se tem alguém que conhece daqui da South America, daqui da América do Sul, é o Wes. E se tem alguém que conhece o Tesca de lá de fora, é o próprio Sandstorm, meu, muito doideira. Caraca!
I love that decision from the Sandstorm to go for that weapon toss down, keeping himself safe. Oh, the turnaround down air. Got the wall touch.
Weapon throw up, yep.
Okay, he's safe.
Huge opportunity goes for the read on the jump. It's not going to be a jump, but falls with the side air. Hold on. Sandstorm is still in a position to get this stock. Wow, that down doesn't hit as well, but that side air does connect. He'll have to spend a lot of resources to come back now.
No, but he has enough to get to that wall, got that touch, and he's added up a lot of good damage.
Caraca, caraca, tentou, mas não rolou. Ixi. Que dor no coração. Essa partida vai ser difícil virar, viu? Vai pro jogo 5, mano. Pouquinho jogo. Não. Ele fez duas leituras seguidas, mano.
Keeping West on his toes, the Neutralite will finally finish that stock off of Sandstorm, but I really feel like Sandstorm has found his flow state against West right now. He's done such a good job spacing out West, making West go for these hits and misses.
And it's so tough too, because you don't get boots experience like that. It's really Sandstorm, Radish, and West are like the people that I think of that like really do it. And so like if Sandstorm decides he wants to play boost that day, West doesn't really have like much to do in terms of like preparation for this, right? And clearly it's working, but West is slowly starting to whittle his way back into this game. Sandstorm still needs to win this game and another one. You can't forget, just getting one game of Tesca is not the end all be all.
Yeah, I mean, it ain't over till it's over. West knows that. He's still playing this one out. It's another Neutralite. Couple more of those could be enough to take down Sandstorm. Side air is not going to quite do it for the weapon.
Nice, nice. Trollzinho ali no ponto certo. Let's go, let's go.
And he's only in the light red, too, here. I mean, you get caught by a Taros and Sig. Like, I think we've all been in the last stock situation, been hit by that, and then cried afterward. So we'll see if Sandstorm's able to close it out. He burns his dodge here a little bit scarily, and I wouldn't want to be in the corner if I'm Sandstorm's, too, against the Taros, man. He's whiffing a lot. The pressure's getting to him.
Caraca, esse Jair não pegou, mano. Nossa, ficou muito na fuça dele. Ele voltou pro Rayman, galera. Voltou pro Rayman. Gauntlets EX. Muito bom, muito bom, muito bom.
With the 3-2-1 brawl has been shouted by the crowd as we go into game 5 of the elimination finals. Both of these players looking at their shot for an opportunity at the gold and also another chance to try and defeat Kaina, who is sitting pretty on the
Caraca.
Side.
See who can get into the grand finals. This game decides who it's going to be. There's a burn dodge from West, but Sandstorm went high, was not expecting that opportunity.
It's going to hurt. Sandstorm trying to get his legs on him now. And West doing it with the hands. A little bit of a... It's like I'm watching Steve Fox.
Caraca, nice! No!
Stared that fist in the face, got a little whiff of it, but still outspaced it and got some hits for it.
You can smell the rubber of the gloves. Oh, and he's trying to hold that advantage. I respect it, but now he's unarmed, and it means West is going to pick up this weapon, and he does that D-light a little bit too high. It goes right over the head of West.
Ah, no, ele deve ter invertido.
How in the world? Great break for Sandstorm, I guess, but West is definitely kind of scratching his head at that one, I'm sure.
Yeah, I mean, he went just enough to the right that Sandstorm ended up bouncing off that corner and going up, keeping himself alive. He just gave that away to West right there, going for that ground pound onto the stage.
Oh, dodge is down as well. West gets the end line. It's going to be enough, but only a very slight baby lead. But I feel like in this situation, we've actually seen West do such a great job of tacking up extra damage. He usually opens up with like a weapon throw into an end light in this situation as well. And it almost happened right there. Sandstorm with better defense, though.
I'm staying high. Oh,
again these weapon throws.
And they go dodge for dodge there. Sandstorm knows he needs that one hit to finish off this stock. Trying to keep this one close, but he also doesn't
want
to
damage. Morreu. Draga.
Is gonna be the stock evener. I'm surprised he didn't go for a side air.
No, same, but I guess, I mean, at that point, if he knew, man, you know, that wall slip was playing a hefty game and he spent a lot of resources, maybe he just did the math. Ow.
Totally valid, but West on this axe once again.
Oh. Olha essas conexão. Ui, meu Deus do céu.
That one will, but it gives Sandstorm the stage control. Oh, up toss.
Up toss has been saving this dude's life all tournament. Right there, another example of it. He's trying to cook again. Gets a nice side air as well. He's getting a pretty decent read on West right now, and he needs this because he's behind by so much. He carries him off stage, and is he just going to play the game? He goes for the ground pound. He does go for it. Oh, but he
got it. Caraca, meu Deus. Pega a arma dele, pelo amor de Deus.
It was not enough. You know he wanted to chase for more, but he's deeper red than West is. Nice nair. Gives him some safety.
Wow, what a weapon spawn. And the end light is not going to be enough. We're going to need one more from West, but Sandstorm burns. Yes.
Que? Okay, what an option from West. Ai, tá vivo.
Enough. Whips West over to the right side, but he's got enough movement with these gauntlets. He'll get to the wall.
Oh.
Sandstorm just off the mark there.
Oh, man, they are trying to hang on.
Don't see him, no. Ai. Nice. Não. Cacilda, mano. Dá pra ganhar, velho. Dá pra ganhar. Let's go, let's go.
Stock left for Sandstorm. West not quite in that KO percent, but he's already adding up the damage. Downlight recovery.
Caraca, não deu KO.
Apocalypse ceiling just high enough to keep West alive.
Right, Sandstorm has to fish some more, and every time he tries to fish is another opportunity for West to get something. Great space from Sandstorm yet again, but he's not able to get the fight.
Vai, mano. Vai, vai, vai. Ai, meu Deus. Eu tô nervoso, eu tô nervoso.
Sandstorm, half a stock behind. He's just a little more damage, but if he gets the right reads, he can take this.
All right, playing from behind here. Strap on your seatbelts, everyone.
Oh, meu Deus. Bora, Brasil versus Brasil. Let's go, mano. Let's go. Mano, até esqueci de fazer o jabá, mano. Dá suporte no canal, sendo membro a partir de R$2,99. A partir de R$7,99 no canal principal, você pode receber uma análise, velho. Uma análise de replay minha. Ai, e nosso servidor do Discord tá na descrição. Deixa nos comentários o que tu achou dessa partida. Insano.
Potentially, two of them could go to one person.